Hi, I'm John Kendall, product manager at Cockroach Labs. Kubernetes is the Google-built container orchestration system, making it easier to deploy, scale, and manage apps built on cloud-native architectures. Everyone's talking about it. What we don't hear enough about is what to look for in databases that can take full advantage of the value of Kubernetes. In this video, we'll explore four properties of Kubernetes native databases. Disposability, API symmetry, shared nothing, and horizontal scaling. Now onto the first property, disposability, which is the ability of a database to handle disruptions, such as processes stopping, starting, or crashing with little to no notice. In the cloud, these disruptions happen randomly. In Kubernetes, pods are mortal by design. Now, this property is important in Kubernetes because of the Kubernetes scheduler, which determines which pods run on which worker nodes based on a configurable set of rules. And when these disruptions occur, Kubernetes reschedules pods to more suitable nodes. Now, in NoSQL databases like MongoDB and distributed SQL databases like cockroachDB, this is a non-event. However, in traditional relational databases, users may be impacted by it because of the way failovers handled. It can result in inconsistent data. So to summarize, machines are expected to go down, and databases with the disposability property make this a non-event. Now on to the second property, API symmetry. Every server in a database should provide the same answer to the same question. Now this is important because of Kubernetes services, which serves as like a routing layer in Kubernetes, allowing clients to address a group of pods as a whole through a single static IP and port pair. Now interestingly, traditional relational databases actually perform better than NoSQL systems here, because when all queries are being sent to one machine, you'll get the same result every time. However, with NoSQL systems that can scale out to multiple machines and can use asynchronous replication, API symmetry can be violated. And looking at distributed SQL databases, using techniques like consensus replication allow databases to achieve API symmetry without sacrificing disposability. Now to wrap up, combining API symmetry with Kubernetes service objects, we can have a single logical database with the consistency guarantees of a single machine database, despite there actually being potentially dozens or even hundreds of nodes working behind the scenes powering this single logical database. Let's look at the third property, shared nothing. We must eliminate single points of failure. This is important because the cloud shouldn't have a maintenance window. True cloud native services should have the capability to be always on. And building on the disposability property, where we said that we're resilient in the face of disruptions and we're okay with Kubernetes rescheduling pods on the fly, shared nothing databases takes this a step further in saying that we shouldn't have a single point of failure or any kind of centralized coordinator, which is common in distributed systems. In fact, Kubernetes itself is not a shared nothing system with its single point of failure control plane that resides in one region. Also failing at shared nothing, traditional relational databases, which are notorious for having single points of failure. But there's hope. CockroachDB as a distributed SQL database is a shared nothing system. There are no single points of failure by having a primary special coordinator process. Any node can fail. And so to wrap up, shared nothing databases, we're saying that we must eliminate single points of failure to allow us to have cloud native services that do not have maintenance windows. And moving on to the fourth and final property of Kubernetes native databases, horizontal scaling, which is the idea of increasing throughput by adding more nodes rather than vertically scaling by buying a bigger and more expensive machine. And this is critical because it's inherent to cloud native architectures, and Kubernetes makes this process easy. In Kubernetes, using the replication controller, one can manage horizontal scale in a declarative way. You simply state how many pods you want to power a component within your architecture, Kubernetes is watching, and Kubernetes reacts by adding or removing pods until it meets your desired state. And with traditional relational databases, horizontal scaling is hard. One can attempt to have sharding within their database, but this will dramatically increase operational overhead. And on the bright side, NoSQL databases, they horizontally scale quite easily. They're well known to do so and architected to do that. And in the same way, distributed SQL databases horizontally scale easily, and they incur no downtime in the process. And so to wrap up, combining Kubernetes service objects that we talked about earlier and the idea of horizontal scaling here, one can have the impression of a single database that just got twice as powerful with costs that scale more linearly because of horizontal scaling rather than costs that grew exponentially that typically happens with vertical scaling. And now let's recap the four properties of Kubernetes native databases that we just discussed. Disposability, API symmetry, shared nothing, and horizontal scaling. And for some time, the databases that we've depended on in the past that didn't have all these properties were pretty much forced to be relegated outside of Kubernetes. But now, with distributed SQL databases like cockroachDB that have all these properties, can thrive being orchestrated with Kubernetes. And finally, I encourage you to see this for yourself. Check out our documentation on how to orchestrate cockroachDB with Kubernetes. And I also encourage you to check out our blog posts on this topic. Thank you for listening.